Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, my word! Have you ever seen anything like that?
Hey, look at that!
Problems there.
And here comes Hurst. He's got some people on the pitch. They think it's all over. It is now.
Hello and welcome to They Think It's All Over, the sports quiz that's been slipped to bung. Our team captains are two men whose performances for England have brought joy to millions of Australians, Swedes, Belgians and Sri Lankans, David Gower and Gary Lineker. David's regular partner is a man so bald he doesn't dare go to snooker matches for fear of being polished. Lee Hurst, and Gary's teammate is a man so hairy that the last time he visited the Empire State Building, he was machine gunned down by biplanes. Roy McGrath. David's special guest is a man with a schoolboy's enthusiasm for football. In fact, the only payment he'd take for coming along tonight was a bag of gobstoppers. John Watson, and alongside Gary, is an impressionist who can do more sportsmen in a week than the Thames Valley breathalyzer unit. Alistair McGowan. Round one is our celebrations round. We show each team the celebration following a goal, and what we want to know is why the players are doing what they're doing. David's team goes first. Your goal comes from the World Cup in 94, Nigeria versus Greece.
And he's got a free man to his right as well, and a chance here for Nigeria to take the lead, and they have.
Benini George, that's a great goal.
That guy, his name's different depending on what part of the world he's playing in. If he's playing in Europe... No, seriously, if he's playing in Europe...
It's the same with Lord Lucan, isn't it?
If he's playing in Europe, he's Finidi George, but if he's playing on another continent, he's known as George Finidi.
Why is that?
Well, because that's just the way it is. He's not George.
So you heard it here first.
Yeah.
John Watson tells it that's the way it is.
Why the trouble in Bosnia?
Well, that's the way it is.
Do you have problems normally remembering these names?
Well, I tend to sort of practice them in bed the night before the game.
Doesn't that bother your wife, you share that?
She's not always there on a Friday.
You're in a hotel room on a Friday night on your own and you're shouting out men's names. Have the papers got hold of this yet, John? You know.
Well, possibly, but...
That's the way it is.
I just try and...
Do you feel at all inclined to answer the question?
Now, the Greek manager had insulted the African players about 2 days before the game, I think, and the Nigerians decided if they scored, they would make an insulting gesture in their celebrations as a sort of,
to piss them off.
Well, the Greek manager, yeah.
That's absolutely correct, yeah. Finidi George was showing what he would like to do to the Greek manager. He's apparently a great bloke, but you can never get him in the bath at full time. Right, Gary's team, a bit of scintillating FA Cup action for you, in which lowly Kingstonian take on mighty Peterborough.
Hit the ball in from the free kick, and Vines gets up, and there's the header, and it's in!
Any ideas?
Not many.
I wasn't talking generally.
Is it what Finidi George does when he's offered a biscuit?
Does he lie down and he has a tummy tickle?
It looked like some sort of dead insect. Was it Graham Kelly?
I think what Gary was going to say there was, well, I thought what Gary was going to say was that the lad there, you know, he kept his eyes closed. That's a problem. He's gone up for a header. Seriously, he's gone up for a header and he's kept his eyes closed, which is bad technique in anybody's book.
Is it Dying Beetle? Is it John Lennon dance or something?
Rory McGrath, the people's friend. No ideas.
No.
I'm going to give you one point for knowing that it was the dying something.
John, I think
what happened was the goal scorer there is a guy called Andy Russell. And
he was rustling, weren't he?
That particular week, I saw him a couple of times. Once was in a betting shop, and the other time was in a nightclub in Kingston, near the ground, and there was a dance going around at the time called the Dying Crab. And he said, if I score on Saturday against Peterborough, I'm going to do the Dying Crab.
And let's face it, if you want something dying on you, it's better to have crabs die than insects, isn't it?
Fantastically accurate. That's exactly what it was.
Nick, we haven't got a chance tonight, have we?
I don't know, you could tape his mouth up. Yeah, that's entirely correct. So you get another 2 points there, because I've already given them one.
Have you got any questions where John Watson's commentary's not on them?
It's a disease with you, John, isn't it? Anorexia nervosa.
So the score at the end of the first round is Gary's team with 1 and John Motson with 5. OK, on to our photo fit round. We've savagely ripped apart some well-known sporting faces and reassembled them at random. All our teams have to do is identify where the bits originally come from. David's team's first. Which spawn of Satan is this?
is that Rory McGrath under incredible G-forces? I tell you what, that is actually Ken Dodd's hair, and it's his face, because he's in disguise, it's a cash gig, no VAT.
Is it the reason that Jimmy Greaves gave up drinking?
Do you know that Jimmy Greaves wrote a novel, you probably know that, John, don't you? About a washed-up, drunken footballer called Jackie Groves.
He does know a lot, John, doesn't he? Do you know where my car keys are?
I know they did this in a recent show, but you know Graham Gooch had his hair transplant. Mm-hmm. Is this sort of the unfinished version again where, you know, that bit's...
Absolutely right, Graham Gooch's hair.
Look, if you cover the top bit and the bottom bit up, that's definitely Nigel Mansell.
Yeah, I'll give you a point for that. Nigel Mansell, the only man who goes to Nick Faldo for charisma lessons.
Well, what about the tennis player? What about Greg Rozetsky? Is that how you say it?
Absolutely right. Greg Rozetsky. Oh,
hey. What a bit of luck.
Greg Rozetsky, right. Your points. John, remind me never to invite you to my house for dinner.
Otherwise, coming tomorrow night.
Is it Friday already?
Okay, on to Gary's team. What bastard child of Beelzebub have we here?
She runs my local brothel. Apparently.
Is it Graham Souness's eyes?
Is it Graham? Yes, it is indeed Graham Souness. That's very good. Yeah. Did you see that? He received £750,000, I think, from the Sunday People, because they compared him to a rat. The rat obviously got £1 million, but...
Is that chin there the former Wolves manager? I mean, former England manager.
Yes, the soon-to-be former Wolves manager.
Princess Anne's hair, before you sneak away without giving us a point.
Absolutely right,
trouble.
So you've got all three. Let's Princess split it up, just
but
check.
Who does the earring belong to? That's what we want. Is it Graham Taylor's earring?
There we go. No. A lot of work for the disadvantage, though, Princess Anne. Married Mark Phillips. OK. So at the end of that round, Gary's team have got 4 and David's team have got 8. And time now for our teams to reveal that artistic streak they kept so well hidden during their playing careers, as they play with their electronic pencils. This week it's cricket, and with England's upcoming tour of South Africa in mind, we'd like you to look at this clip of fearless natural-born Englishman Graham Hick squaring up to South Africa's fearsome Alan Donald. We've cunningly covered up the terrifying war paint on Donald's face that caused Hick to panic and lose his wicket. What we'd like our teams to do is paint in where they think Donald applied his sunblock. Right, David Steam, it's you first.
About a bit higher.
It looks like
that was not.
It looks like he's been out in the piss with a bottle of Advocar.
Earrings? No, I don't know. Some little nice little drop earrings. By and large, the gist of it is it goes all over there and all over there. Spectacles.
Either that or a pair of bollocks. Sorry, Mum.
Nick, if yours are yellow, there's probably a couple of doctors.
All right, let's get rid of your scribblings and let Gary's team have a go.
Well, I think if you just put a little mark across there like that, you see, and you take it up there like that, bring it down here. You see, probably had a bit on there like you see, and he put a bit up there like that, you see, and went up there and like that, and he turned him into a nice red Indian, you see. Can you tell what it is yet?
Spooky, it was almost as if we had David Vine in the room with us.
I'll tell you what, why don't we let Rolf Harris have a go?
That's just my phone number. In case there are any women here who prefer something a little hairier. Go on, Crispy.
Pretty much as David did. But...
Well, do it identically, because he got it right.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to the Corinthian spirit?
Sorry?
Motty drank it.
Okay, well, let's take the scribblings away and see where the sunblock was actually applied.
Mm-hmm.
And let's reapply your scribbles.
Ah, oh, right. That's perfect, so good. Hang on, we've got the lip. I'm sure the bottom lip.
See Gary's as well.
Nick, can I just say at this stage that aren't Stoke playing very well at the moment?
Very, very well.
They're
miles above Port Vale.
Well. Okay, so that's 3 points to Gary's team. And at the end of that round, Gary's team have 7 and David's team have 8. It's half-time now, which for millions of sports fans means warm lager, greasy hot dogs and a 100-yard queue for the toilets. But for us, it's worse than that. Our teams are forced to revoice old bits of sporting footage. David's team goes first. Your clip comes from earlier this year and features England's attempts to stop the Incredible Hulk, otherwise known as Jonah Lomu.
Well, I don't know. How does one person go through an entire English rugby team? Well, I must stop thinking about Princess Diana. This Jonah Lomu, he's big, he's going to be on the left wing, he's wearing black, you can't miss him, but if I were you, I'd try too hard.
Captain, somebody's rubbing my thigh.
Oh, I know the feeling, love. Never mind, good luck, let's go do it.
And let's remember what Paul McKenna said. I'm Jonah Lomu, I am a tank, and no one can stop me. I'm a tank and... Oh, no, it's England. I'm a small child with rickets, and no one can stop me. They will never beat me. God, English rugby tackles are like buses. You wait for one, then three come along at once. Anyway, now, that was good. Now, where's that blonde bird with a tiara?
Gary's team, for you, it's that great American sportsman and lovable family man, O.J. Simpson. Now, we have to be very careful what we say about O.J., after all, he murdered his wife and he's a dangerous bloke. We take you right back to the day he went for that quiet Sunday afternoon drive in the company of the entire Los Angeles police force. We've asked Alistair to commentate and provide analysis in the voices of Trevor Brooking and Alan Hansen.
Well, there's Orgy there in the white van. It's the away kit, obviously, normally wears the red van. And four defenders there after him all on the line. There's flat back four, they're not going to do anything. There's some people on the pitch there, and they think it's all over. And, well, it is now, because I've taken over the commentary and everyone's sweet stuff. But, you know, you're going round, there's OJ there in the van, he's nipping in and out. Pretty reminiscent of that in Devonshire when I was playing on my old team. West Ham used to do a lot of that sort of thing, you know. Well, there's our friend OJ again from a different angle, and that is quality defending there, either side of him. He's going nowhere.
Yeah, O.J. Simpson, a man who's just signed a lucrative sponsorship deal with Kitchen Devil.
Did
you watch the trial?
The trial, yeah, yeah.
I used to watch it every Sunday night. I used to sit there having a right good laugh. We chat, because they're all shouting and honouring each other, and I did it.
Right, back to the contest with Gary still on 7 and David on 8. It's time for Author Author, where we ask the teams to identify whose sporting autobiographies these touching reminiscences come from. David's team, which irresponsible-sounding member of the cricketing fraternity, is this.
The unfortunate boy that was killed was standing as umpire. I'm glad to say that the players, who were the indirect cause of the boy's death, were in no way to blame.
Hang on. Unfortunate boy killed. Was it Colonel Mustard in a library with a candlestick? The unfortunate boy that was killed. Right, that's really old.
Old-fashioned literature.
Yeah.
I think it's somebody like Sir Jack Hobbs or maybe W.G. Grace writing an autobiography.
I think it could be the Bodyline series. And it's funny, actually, in women's cricket, there's been an uproar recently because they've had the Body Form series. Where, they're actually aiming for the box.
They're not called that in women's cricket.
Aren't they?
No.
What are they called?
Manhole covers.
Why would they be called manhole covers?
Like I'm back at school. Can I just suggest something to your team, right? You two have got
nothing
right so far, and John's got nearly everything. Perhaps you should ask him.
You know, when we won the other week, he was under the desk.
I wonder why I had that smile on you.
Yeah, not with you. Well, I've got to stab at it, haven't I? Mm,
but you did say two people.
All right, W.G. Grace, then, go on.
W.G. Grace is the correct answer.
There's a surprise.
Right, W.G. Grace, ancient English cricketer and star of Are You Being Served?
Motty, have you seen W.G. Grace in a bookie from Kingston?
And then in a nightclub?
No, but I dreamt about him the other night and he just came back to me.
Well, beard, isn't it?
Moving swiftly on. Right, Gary's team. You can learn a lot about a bloke in a programme like this.
Dead right.
Gary's team, who is this pervy-sounding insomniac?
John Motson.
That night, John and I went back to my room in the village. Jenny Stout was there. I had bought an immense bar of Swiss chocolate. I now took this out of my bag, laid it on the bed and said, right, here goes. We didn't get much sleep that night.
It's Frank Boff seducing the Milky Bar Kid.
Sounds like something by Julian Clary as well, but he's not a sports person. Incidentally, he has written a book about football.
Has he?
Yeah, he wrote a chapter about West Ham, and he said, West Ham have got to take a firm hold of their dicks.
Has anybody else you could do an impression of written a book about sports?
Jack Charlton wrote an autobiography called Remember Me by, oh.
The one I see in the mirror when I look in the mirror, what's his name, that fella?
Alistair, do an impression of Motty and you're about to get it right.
All right. Go on, have a go.
Well, actually, I do know this.
Mr. and Mrs. Venables. Chocolate was Terry's.
I just like to thank the Cracker Firm for all of Gary's jokes tonight.
But we do know who this is, don't we?
It's not Sally Gunnell, is it?
It is indeed Sally Gunnell. That's right, from her book Running Tall. Mind you, if the bar of chocolate was Toblerone, it's no wonder she was out injured for the World Championships, is it? At the end of that round, Gary's team have got 10 and David's team have got 11. And now the round which was invented solely to give Rory McGrath a chance to make contact with the human race. It's our field, the sportsman round. Dave and Lee, you're first. If you'd like to go and take your positions, please.
Oh. Jimmy Green's leave now.
OK, got the blindfolds on. And can we have our first mystery sports person, please? OK, your 90 seconds... Your 90 seconds starts now.
Good luck. Hang on, I've got to go.
Oh, hang on. Dan, come down with me. Slow to speak. Blimey.
Where's it...
His patella's popped out. That's a nasty injury there. I'd get that seen to by the Duke. Is there an osteopath here? Is this a giant frog?
It's a small one.
A small one?
Yeah.
Is it Cantona? Oh!
Hang on, hold it.
Dave, little tip, mate.
What?
It's a cricketer. All right. I reckon he's just going through a few puberty, look.
Can you just hurry it along? He was eating beans.
I'm going to stand up and those knees must be killing you.
Oh.
Hang on, it's only a short one.
Yeah, that's popped back in nicely now. That's all.
Time though. Running out. Five
it's Jack Russell.
Absolutely correct.
Well done, David.
Okay, Gary and Rory, your turn. Two marks, please. Take your blindfolds with you.
How's it
gone? Alistair, if it's someone you recognise, you do an impression of. Do an impression of. Or her.
Right, here we go.
Can we have our second mystery guest, please?
Something again.
Okay, your 90 seconds start now.
Oh dear. it's a sheepskin.
No, it's not a sheep, Gary.
Wait!
Have we met before?
it must be some sort of commentator.
It's a commentator.
It must be.
What's that? Is that you, Gary?
Sorry? Hang on. Definitely not Jimmy Hill.
I can feel his chin, it's moving.
Yeah,
it's, is it a commentator? Yeah. What's it? Oh, what's this? Not Motty, is it?
Absolutely correct. Well done, Motty. Rory, could you take your blindfold off the top of your head? Okay, so at the end of that round, Gary's team has 13 and David's team has 14. Right, the winning post is there in the distance, but first our teams have to negotiate the name game. You get 90 seconds and no rhyming clues. But just in case, we've been careful to leave out James Hunt. Right. David's team, you're in the lead, so you go first. Pass that to Lee. OK, Lee, your 90 seconds start now.
Golfer, and his first name sounds like stealing stuff, and he's British.
Nick Faldo.
Correct. South African and then British, then South African, woman runner, no shoes, pork.
Solar bud.
bloke, his second name sounds like, ooh.
Boom.
Tit. Yeah, his second name, that's the first syllable, the second name. And it's like,
come on.
It's like, first name is like, right said.
Fred Titmus.
Correct. National Hunt jockey, first name is like, the Lionheart.
Richard Dunwoody.
Oh, he's good, isn't he? Swedish tennis player, you'd wipe your feet on him if you're walking in a house if there are a couple of them.
Max Verlander.
That's it, yes. Austrian skier, and his first name sounds like... it doesn't sound like Frank. What a silly thing to say. But,
Frank,
but
yeah.
He's got like at the end, like
snoring.
Frank Snorer. No, he's he's like, it's a load of noise, something like adulation. It's like a thing that opens up in the sea and you eat them. What am I talking about?
We're going to lose this game.
He's this Austrian skier, do you know?
Clamour, Franz Clamour.
Correct. English football, England goalkeeper.
Seaman.
That's it, yes. His first name is you have it with a burger, but only one, and you say, I'm complaining about that, I want it more.
Chip Beck.
Correct.
Very good, so you've got 22, which means that you need 9 to draw level. Pass that through to Rory. It's very tense now. Okay, 90 seconds, start now.
Pundit, talks like my...
Jimmy Hill.
Irish pentathlete, won a gold medal.
Mary
Peters.
Correct. Australian tennis player, ready money...
Cash, yeah.
Golfer, Italian, not a mod, he's a...
Rocker. Costantino Rocker. Right.
Grey horse.
Desert Orchid.
Correct, yes. Football, I think he was crap, played for Tottenham. His second name is a country in South America that sells, makes coffee and speak Portuguese.
Brazil.
Rugby player, his posterior is not summer, spring,
bottom.
Winter bottom.
You get grabbed by the short and hockey player. But his second name is when you get nothing in tennis.
Love. Davis Love the Third. The
brilliant. Goal. Yeah. Oh, Romanian gymnast. Nice arm.
Nadia Comăneci.
Baseball player. It's very young human being.
Babe Ruth.
Yes. I don't know what this bloke does, but his second name is a big hole in the ground. You get rocks out of it.
Crater.
No. Rocks, granite, slab, slate.
Quarry. Don Quarry.
Yeah. Don Quarry, yeah. Hockey player, Jolly Hockey Sticks, woman.
Rachel, no.
She's called Jane Sixsmith. footballer, first name, old footballer, I think he played for Bolton.
That Loftus.
He's dead.
On the whistle. Is this a good time to say that we think Stoke City?
Yes, it is. So that's three more points for David's team, which takes them up to 25. I'm going to minus one from you for saying Jane Sixsmith.
Yeah, quite right.
Even with those adjustments, it means the score at the end of the game is David's team 25, Gary's team 26. Our thanks to David Gower, Lee Hurst and John Motson, and to Gary Lineker, Rory McGrath and Alistair McGowan. We're all off to the motorway service station to pick up brown envelopes stuffed with cash. Join us next week for the last show in the series. My name's Nick Hancock. They think it's all over. It is now.
And Nick Hancock umpires the final round on Thursday at 10:20.